So the D4200 LCD station is what we have in front of us here. And this is where we're going to do all of our programming for the system. First thing we're going to need to do is we're going to need to go into our advanced programming menu. So we're going to start by holding the menu button down. And this will take several seconds. We're going to notice that once it's ready to go, the screen is going to change and it's going to say, please reboot. During the reboot process, we're going to come over and we're going to hold down the zone four down button. We're going to hold that down until it says admin on the screen. When it says that, we know that we're good to go. We can then go into our menu and we have several different options that we did not have before. First thing we're going to set up is we're going to set up our network. So we're going to come here and we're going to push the up arrow until we see edit the network. From edit the network, we can hit select save and we're able to give it an ID. In this case, we're going to use ID of 1 and this is a master station. So we're going to hit select save. 1 will flash. In this case, we don't need to change it, but if we did, we could hit the raise and lower to adjust that. And then we will hit select save again, and that is saved. We can go menu to back out, and now this has an address and can participate on the network. So we're going to look at the start channel, which is under assigned zones. So we can do a start channel. So if we wanted to do sequential numbering, we could just pick our start channel and hit enter. In this case, we will use 1, but we can set that at any number we want. If we want to go in and adjust it on a zone by zone basis, we're going to hit the up arrow key. And from the up arrow key, we see now that it says Z01 channel 1. So we could adjust that and make it any number between 1 and 2048 that we had a dimmer allocated to. The other thing that we will need to set up is we're going to set up how many zones our controller has. By default, the controller has 32 zones, but if we want to use a smaller number than that, we can go in to our miscellaneous settings. And from there, we can scroll until it says max zones. This one is currently set for 16. We want to change that and we want it to be 8. So again, we in configurations of 8, we can adjust this between 8 and 32. And what that means is we only have one page of scenes, of zones here. So our page zones will not do anything in this scenario. If we were using 16, 24, or 32, we could hit that and it would scroll through those other options. So we want to set up our dimmers in here based on our various dimmer types. So we're going to scroll up to local dimmers, select save. And right now we're in dimmer 1 and we can scroll through and we're looking for type, and type can be standard, 2-wire, non-dim, Mark 10, our options. We do support Mark 7 with the use of the PE300, and David spoke about that earlier. So again, in this case, we are just using standard dimmers. So we'll leave it at standard and hit menu and we can get back out. Now, in order to configure our scheduler, we are going to go through here until we get to our scheduler. Because our scheduler is time-based, we will want to go in and set up our date and time. And again, we just go in, we'll adjust our time, our date accordingly, and then hit select save when we're done. So we have the ability to turn on and off our scheduler, and then we can edit our scheduler. So right now, event one does not have a label. It's going to run at 7 days a week at 12 a.m. So we can say what scene will run. So we select the scene that we want to run at a particular time, and that will turn the lights on, off, dim them, whatever we've asked it to do during that time. So to edit labels, we're going to go to where it says edit labels. Hit select save, select the label we would like to edit, and then use the keys here to adjust the names. We can hit clear to clear everything out and then start with a new name. So if we just wanted to call that A, we can do that. In the manual, it does tell there is a chart that shows what button goes with what label. We hit select, and now if we hit the four above the four for our main screen, we can see that it's labeled A. So that's how we're going to do labeling. That's how we're going to set up the size. Now all we have to do, once all of this is done, is program our zones. Now, if we want to exclude a particular zone from a preset, we have zone excludes, and they are in our menu as well. We can go through and exclude a zone. We will set up our presets, again, by simply being at our main screen, raising our levels to whatever we want, or using our master, then hold down until it changes and hitting select save. That will then record our preset, and if we notice, we can push this, the lights will change to that preset, and when we come back, they are there. We can easily bypass the fade time by simply hitting the button quickly twice. So it'll fade to it, but if we want to do it quick, we can push the button twice and it will allow us to do that. So this is our single gang entry stations. Again, as David pointed out when he went through the system architecture, this is available in many different sizes. This particular one gives us scenes 1 through 4 plus off. We do have to set this up. We've done all of our configuration in our master station, and this is just going to talk to our master station and connect between the two. The wire that we've run, again, as David pointed out earlier, is we've run a Belden cable between all of our stations. So that's going to connect our stations and going to plug in on our station here in the Phoenix connector. You're going to notice up above there is a address block. This address block, we have to set a unique address for everything on the network. In order to slave one entry station to a master, we have to set this to the master's address. Our master in this case is 1. So we're going to start by setting it at 1. We're going to hold down scene 1 button as we plug it back up. We're going to hold this down for about 3 to 5 seconds, and you're going to notice the station is flashing. Once the station starts flashing, you can let go. It is now connected to this master. We unplug the station. We change it to a unique address. The station should now be connected to our master. We can push buttons on one and they will reflect here. So we are controlling on that. We can connect one entry station to multiple masters. How we do that is we just do the slave process again. So if I had another master that was 3, I would then set this to 3, hold down scene 1 as I plugged it up, and it would configure it then onto the network and allow me to control both master stations 1 and 3 from a single entry station. So now we're going to show how to set up the aux sensor and get that configured. We're going to configure the aux sensor again by going into our menu. We're going to scroll up until it says miscellaneous settings. Select save. And here there's a lot of different options that we have, but now we have unlock or unoccupied and a scene. So we can enable which scene that we want by hitting select, and we can scroll through our scenes from none, off, scenes 1 through 16, and max. So we can set our unoccupied to be whatever we would like in this. Again, typically unoccupied is going to be off, but it does not have to be. So once you have it set, you're going to hit select save. You're going to scroll up again and you're going to do the occupy. So this is what the lights will come on to be. Again, we can do any of our presets plus max or off. So we can configure that exactly what they want for each individual room. Once we have that configured, there is one more mode. We have a locked mode. So if you want the station from a security standpoint to be able to be locked if there is a signal from a security or a fire alarm so the lights cannot be turned off or cannot be adjusted, we can do that by enabling this, putting it on, and then it would lock the station out. I get either the lock function or the occupancy sensor. I cannot do both at the same time on the same station. The last thing we're going to talk about on the setup is setting up our astro time. And our astro time, we're going to input the latitude and our sunrise and sunset for the given day that we have. And that will allow the controller to then know and very closely estimate when our sunrise and our sunset are for a particular day. So if we wanted to use astro settings for our schedule to turn lights off dusk to dawn, we can do that.
To learn more about Leviton products, please visit Leviton.com.